All right, welcome back to another episode. It is December 26th right now. Yesterday was Christmas, and so Merry Christmas. Obviously, it's a little late, but Merry Christmas. For me, what I did was I just drove up to Georgia from where I live in Florida. It was like about 5 hours, and spent some time with my older brother and his fiance, which was always nice. I always like to spend time with my brother because it's not every day we get to see each other. He's in the military, so we don't get to, you know, see each other all that much. But it was really nice because he had a long weekend, so I was able to drive up, spend the Christmas day with him, and Christmas Eve too. We just kind of hung out, caught up, played some Warzone, so that was really nice. And then I just got back not too long ago, so that's why I wasn't uploading. I was just spending time with some family, and yeah. So all in all, my Christmas was great, and I'll see my like mom and that part of my family probably towards the end of January when I head home to Jersey. So yeah, that's basically how my Christmas was. But CBD has been doing great. I think for the last 2 days we did around 2.8K, maybe 3K in revenue, and today we gave our affiliates a bit bigger cap to push this week, so we should be doing quite a few sales this week, and I'm definitely excited for that. So yeah, I mean, outside from the usual, right now, I told you in the last episode, I want to say, that we were focused on TikTok and possibly getting into physical locations. And so with that said, that's going to be our focus, especially moving into 2024 alongside scaling up the actual affiliate funnel side of our business, right? So right now, I have a couple cards from some vape shops around here for their distributors. And what I'm gonna do is contact them today, see if they're working. Some people aren't working right now, so I'm gonna see if they're working and see how we can get our products into stores. I'm also going to watch a bunch of YouTube videos and read a bunch of things that I can to learn more about how to have success when you get your product into stores. Because for me, at least, I would think that you have to sell your product, and I'm just trying to see how do we sell the product if it's just sitting on a shelf. So I'm trying to think about that and get a little creative with our selling strategy in stores once we get them there. And for TikTok, TikTok Shop, we are producing a ton of videos right now. So come, I want to say January 1st, we're going to start to post and get some traction. So we're just really gearing up to hit 2024 really hard. I know that if we start now, it could work too, but if we just load up a bunch of videos, get a bunch of things ready to test, then it should be pretty solid. So come 2024 January, we're gonna run up TikTok Shop. That's gonna add a whole bunch of new revenue, I'm pretty sure. I'm definitely really pumped for that. We have a bunch of optimizations to make to our e-com site. So that's basically what we're focused on right now: TikTok, retailers, and growing and optimizing the current stuff. So that's what we're up to. And today, what do I have today? Besides just some work, I have obviously the stuff I just mentioned, I'm going to be doing that. It's primarily research, primarily like learning right now, because I've never done that before. And it's a completely new business model, especially the retailers, because my background's all drop shipping and e-commerce. So this is a completely new world to me, which is amazing. I'm really happy that I'm getting involved in this, and it's kind of awesome to see how this business has been progressing. I think that over the next couple of months, we're gonna hit numbers that probably I've never touched before in my life. And so I'm definitely very excited. And over the next couple of years, I think that we're gonna come and dominate the CBD industry. I really do think that we're gonna do that. And then once THC becomes federally legalized, then we'll have distribution for those products as well. So that's a big thing. So that's what we're kind of working on. It's kind of a play over the next couple of years to eventually will happen is THC will become legalized, and we'll be able to have distribution for those kinds of products as well. So should be huge. So I have boxing. I want to say around 5 today. So up until then, I'm probably just going to spend the day reading, researching, and anything that I find that's like, wow, this is super crazy and really useful, I'm gonna start to record again. I'll talk about what I found and how I think that we're gonna apply it to our business, so that you guys can possibly apply it if it makes sense to for yours. So that's the goal of the series, really, is to be documenting everything that I'm doing so that you guys can see the ins and the outs and know exactly what I'm doing and why I'm doing it. So that way, when you know why I'm doing something and how I'm doing something, then you can go ahead and apply that to your business, knowing why and how as well. So that's kind of the point of this series. But it's kind of been growing really quickly. If you look at the channel, we're almost at 200 subscribers now, which is like a lot of people, to be honest, and kind of unexpected. I didn't know it was going to grow this fast. I guess daily uploads definitely help the YouTube algorithm or something. But I'm getting back to daily uploads now, and we're going to keep growing. So I'm definitely excited. And yeah, so I'm going to get into that research, and I'll let you know what I find. All right, so I'm actually driving back right now. I went to the natural store. I got a bunch of milk, a bunch of eggs, a bunch of meat, and some cheese, because I'm really trying to dial in this diet, like this natural diet this coming next couple months. To be honest, I think that health is the most important thing when you're trying to grow your business too, because if you're performing really, really well and you have high energy and, you know, you feel healthy and feel good energy, then that's all going to be translated into your business. So I think that to be, you know, you've probably heard it everywhere, but I think that health is wealth, as they like to say, but it's also what helps you generate wealth. So I'm on my way home right now, but once I get there, I'll do a little haul for what I bought and show you guys about it. But yeah, so I just did that, and earlier in the day, before I went to the store, I finished up a couple videos for our TikTok. We decided we're gonna start to post daily from today, so we'll see how much traction we get. I finished setting up the shop and everything like that a couple days back, so we're just gonna continue to optimize and see what we can do to grow this on TikTok shop. So starting to post daily from today, literally just using the same style of videos I showed you guys in the other episodes, where it's the AI generated images and everything. But yeah, so I'll show you more about that when I get home, and more about what I actually bought. So anyways, I gotta drive back, and I'll see you guys at home. All right, so we just got back home. I literally have to go in like 5 minutes to boxing. So really quickly, here's what I got for the week of groceries. We have a bunch of meat. So we have venison, we have some steak, some ribeye. We got 4 dozen eggs, 2 gallons of raw milk, some good quality olive oil, some tomatoes, some cheese, some raspberries, avocado, and celery. The reason we got the celery was for celery juice. Apparently it's very, very good for you. So tonight I'm probably gonna go ahead and like juice all of the celery to drink it throughout the week. Vegetables themselves are apparently not very easily digestible because of all the fiber in them. So, celery itself. So when you juice it, apparently it takes away the fibers and helps you digest it easier. So that's basically what we got. It's all very healthy. Like you see, I'm trying to just, like I said, I'm trying to dial in this diet because it's just gonna make me feel better overall. It's gonna help with pretty much everything. So that's that. I literally have to get changed, head over to boxing right now. I'll record that. I don't know what we're about to do. I think we're gonna do some pad work, and then later on I'll probably go for a run with Levi. And that's gonna be it. I'm gonna make some more videos probably. Read more about retail and distribution and stuff like that. So that's kind of what I have to go ahead and do today. As for TikTok, the approach that we're going to take with it is we set up our TikTok shop and everything. So we're going to start to put out our own content every day until we get some sales. And once we have some traction going, we set our commission for the affiliates on TikTok at 25% to give it like kind of an enticing thing for them to promote. And once they see we have traction, we think that we'll be able to scale properly through affiliates. So at first, we're starting by ourselves with no TikTok affiliates, but the goal is to scale with affiliates on TikTok later, which are completely different than the affiliates we're using for our other traffic. So TikTok affiliates and the affiliates that I mentioned before are not the same thing. They're affiliates of the company, but they're doing different things. Like the affiliates that we work with that drive traffic to our funnels are running Facebook ads, are doing native, are doing a bunch of other things, right? But these affiliates for TikTok are producing UGC for our brand to make it, you know, good, give us a social presence, and then they can buy it on TikTok shop. So it's a different revenue stream for the company, and that's how we're trying to approach TikTok. Of course, in the following episodes, you'll see if that approach works, and if it doesn't, we'll obviously have to switch it up and come up with a new strategy, but that's what we got going so far. So I'm gonna go get changed and head over to boxing, and then I'll talk to you guys after.
There you go.
All right, so I got back from boxing and I just made myself some celery juice. Apparently it's very, very good for you, so doing that, I had some raw cheese and some celery juice. And now I'm just taking a look at CBD. We gave them a bigger cap this week. They haven't really pushed too much this week. They actually missed their cap last week. But we did 3,000 in revenue today, I'll put it right there. And 2,700 in new sales, and we had $200 in rebills, or yeah, just about. So, or 2,800 in new sales, 200 in rebills. So it's doing okay. These are like our baby scale months. Like, we're not doing any type of volume in comparison to other affiliate CBD companies out there. And so with that said, that just kind of goes to show the level that we're going to be at once we do get the cap increase is going to be crazy. Like, we're going to be doing, I mean, I don't want to jinx anything, but we're going to be doing crazy numbers, numbers that most people don't do, and numbers that you don't do consistently. However, this is going to be consistent, which is going to be even crazier. So we're also very, very excited to see how this goes. Customer support is dialed in. Our refunds are kind of getting down there a little bit more. The only thing is that we haven't rolled out that course that I was talking about yet, the course where we kind of talk about how to use the reef or how to use the products and how to basically use our CBD. We haven't rolled that out at all yet, so that hasn't been in effect. We've just changed our scripts a little bit. It's going to take a little bit more time for us to actually roll that course out, because obviously it takes a lot of production. So for us to do that, it's probably going to be when we start to scale up, so that way we can use the resources from the business to invest into building the course, because it's going to take money to hire the actor and script the course and all that stuff. So we're going to go ahead and get that done probably in January. But for the time being, our main focus is obviously customer experience, making sure that's very good with customer support. That's really it. So, I mean, customer support's a big, big piece of the business. But yeah, so about $3,000 in revenue today. It's kind of been the same scale we've been at for the last couple of days. And that's about it for CBD for the day. I had no calls for Revilify, which is my other business. So pretty calm day today. And sorry, my team sent in some funny text messages right now. So pretty calm day, but very, very grateful that I'm even here right now building this. It's a business that I didn't ever expect to even be in, CBD. So, but now we have the next couple of years not mapped out. Obviously, you never know what's going to happen in business, but we have some plays that we want to make in the next couple of years that's going to make this company even crazier than it already is. And I think it's going to be massive, and very excited for the future of it. And honestly, I'm just glad that I'm able to document this whole thing for myself and publicly, and for eventually whenever my kids are born and they watch these, they're like, oh, this is what dad did. So it's gonna be pretty dope. to be able to look back at this and say, oh yeah, this month we did 100K as the company's doing 50 million a year, right? So it's gonna be pretty neat. I'm pretty happy about that. And honestly, just happy for the experience of building this kind of a company, because it's so unique. You just get to figure out different problems to solve and different ways to grow and get strategic. It's just super nice, because dropshipping, you don't always get to do that. Of course, you can absolutely be strategic with dropshipping. You can absolutely solve a lot of problems. There are a lot of problems to solve, and it's a great way to get your foot in the door with business. But then once you start a real brand, it's like just so much better. You just feel more passionate about it, more happy about building it. And that's at least for me, I feel that way. And so it's been an amazing process. But all right, guys, that's about it for today's episode. Tomorrow's will be a bit more insightful. I'll talk more specific about the things that we're doing, but I really think that 1 million is incoming. We're at like 197 subscribers right now, which is crazy too. Like, this YouTube's been growing so quickly, so I'm also happy about that, of course. But I'm just gonna keep putting out value, keep putting out these episodes. I hope you guys are taking things away from them. And as always, if you have any actual specific questions for me, just drop a comment. I think tomorrow I'll talk more about how we get our fulfillment, how we sourced our fulfillment and all that stuff. To kind of tell you guys how you can do it, but just without actually dropping all my secret sauce. So, I'm going to do everything that I can. Sorry, these text messages, man. I'm going to do everything that I can to make sure that you guys get a lot of value from these videos without trying to reveal everything. So tomorrow, more insightful video, more detailed on how we're going to roll out these videos for TikTok. And I mean, I already gave you our strategy. We're just pumping a bunch of videos ourselves, and then we're going to get affiliates to sign up and pump them too. But yeah, all right. Anyways, that's it for today's video, guys. 3K in revenue, really solid. No Rebuilify clients signed today, so that's all good too. But we're getting heavily focused for 2024. We're dialing in diet. We're dialing in the CBD business. We're dialing in Rebuilify. Everything is dialed right now, and I'm just super excited for the next couple of months. I know they're going to be crazy, and I'm super excited to share them with you guys. So thank you guys, as always, for watching. Definitely comment if you have any questions, and I'll see you guys in the next episode.